today I'm going to paint a walleye pattern. I have one already on my channel. This is a more realistic walleye pattern that I came up with that I'm going to share with you today. This is a 6-inch minnow, and I already got a white base coat on it. And so we're going to start with black. You could have probably started with black, but I don't because I need the belly white as well. So let's just get it all black. I'm using the Wicked paint, Wicked Black. Use any black. It all black, and I'm going to heat set. I heat set with a hair dryer in between every single coat. Alright, so that's all dry. I got some like a loofah or scale pattern piece of material. Wrap it. Alligator clips. Kind of snug, but not too tight where you're going to scratch the bait. There's no wrinkles on the material. Good. Okay. Now, I got testers, Aztec pearl gold. I think it does a dinger bait. Out of all the pearls that I've shot, the Aztec was way better than everything else I've used. And then I use just a little bit of reducer to thin it out. Sometimes it's kind of hard to spray pearls, but like I said, I usually don't have problems. But I like to thin it out a little bit. Mix it up. Spray the gold right over the black. I'm not going to spray the belly gold because it's going to be white. Actually, I could have left it white, but I forgot. I'm going to heat set that. Maybe do one more coat. I want that gold pearl accent or the pearlized colors to come through some of the other layers. Pearl effect is the words I'm looking for. Alright, we'll do a color change and then we'll go on to the next color. Alright, the next color we're going to add, again, I still have the scale masking on. Sometimes I like to use these FW ink paints, and this one's antelope brown. It's almost like a sepia type color. So shake it up real good. And I will do a very light coat of this over the gold. Oops. We'll darken it up a little bit. Tones down the gold a little bit. As we get closer to that walleye color. Just a couple passes. that's it. So a little goes a long way. And now we'll take the masking off. You kind of see some of the scale pattern, and then when you clear coat it, actually, you'll be able to see it way better. So I'm gonna clean the brush, and then we'll start getting into a little bit more of the details. All right, the next color is gonna be Wicked Sepia. It's not a base color, it's more for highlighting colors, and if you don't have this, you need to get sepia. And this is where it really brings the paint to life. So we're going to add some stripes. And for some people this part could be tricky because we're going to do them by hand. I'd used a reference photo and saw that while I have just three or four big wide stripes on the sides. And that's what we're going to do. Turn your pressure down so you have more control. And I'm going to kind of go into like a V shape. Start V, but I round out the bottom, go real lightly. Kind of see a little bit there. Do another one. Third one. And a little one here on the end of the tail. Like that. And then you do the same thing on the other side. One, I try to match them up. Two, three, there's four. So there's stripes on both sides. Now you're going to get the back. Sepia is really going to enhance these colors, the antelope brown and that gold. See that? Okay, now I'm going to do a little bit of sepia on the gill area. Doesn't take much to make something look real. Okay, we'll heat set that and we'll move on to the next color. Now, while I have kind of iridescent eyes, and while I have the white out, I sprayed a little bit of the white. It's kind of a dusting on top of the iridescent eyes. And well, so while you have the white out, do that to your eyes. Next, what you need to do is we have to give the gill a little bit of a white highlight. And I cut out a piece of masking. I know it's like plastic, you can use anything, cardboard. And we go right up against the gill here, just so I can protect the gill. And just go a little bit away. Back and forth, just the bottom portion of the gill plate. It's a little bit. I may even add a bit more than that. Side. then, also from a reference photo, there's a white mark on the tip of the tail. I do that on an angle. Same thing on the other side. And then, the white belt. And I actually want a little bit of that overspray coming up the belly area. So I'll come up a little bit off the sides here. There you go. There you go. That's one. I may come in and darken these white areas just a little bit more.